early model Jeeps, they didn't put these vacuum motors on here. They had the two wipers connected with a connecting rod, and you could operate it by hand on either side. Interesting feature on some of the first Jeeps were these headlights. You could take the wing nut off, lift this up. You can turn these into the engine compartment so you could see what you were working on at night. Assuming your battery still worked, then you had to reposition that headlight, get it back down again. Put that wing nut back on. Then on later model Jeeps, they didn't bother putting this on anymore. It's too much trouble and a few more parts that they didn't have to make. Ignition switch. The starter is on the floorboard by the accelerator pedal. You have a choke, hand throttle. That's World War II cruise control. Panel lights only work if the switch here is in service position. You pull this out and only your blackout lights will work. You have another switch for blackout here. They didn't want this to accidentally come on to full bright lights, headlights or that, if you were in a blackout zone. Push this release button. You hang out to a service position, then your headlights and your tail lights, your brake light will work. Bring this all the way out in the daytime and your regular brake light will work. Relatively complicated switch, also had a circuit breaker built into it. And then down on the floorboard on this side is the dimmer switch for the headlights. Horn button. A bracket to hold the point of the shovel, the handle of an axe, The axe blade fit up inside this bracket here, and the handle of the shovel was strapped down there. Earlier Jeeps, you had to lift the driver's cushion to put gas in the tank. Then later on, they put the filler neck over here on the side